Hallelujah. Welcome, somebody on board. Good morning. If you're in Africa, in another country, whatever time it is in your country, we are greeting you by the grace of God. Kaidre, invite somebody on board. Hallelujah. We thank God for the grace. Yes, thank you, Lord, for giving us yet another chance. It is a morning in my country, and I thank God that He has given us time to minister to the church once again. We don't take it for granted. Even having, you know, the gift of life, we don't take it for granted. It has really costed Him. It has costed God quite something for us to be alive this morning and to be able to reach out to the church by the grace of God. Hallelujah. I'm waking you up. For those who are in Africa, I'm waking you up. Wake up. Let us hear the word of the Lord, because He's faithful. God is faithful. He has really been a good God to us, and we thank Him for the grace in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. We thank God. We thank God. Greetings to you all. I'm waking somebody up. Wake up and hear the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Welcome, somebody. If you're coming aboard, kindly wake somebody up. Share the video. Share the word, so that even as I minister, we shall be together. Physically, you know, many other times we say, I'm with you in the spirit. I don't want you to be with me in the spirit alone. I also want you to give me company this morning by the grace of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Welcome, somebody. I have a word for you. I've been laboring the entire night in my country, so I have something that is going to bless your life, because it has come from the mouth of the Lord. The Lord spoke to me yesterday, so I have a word. I have a word for us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. I want to encourage the church in Africa. I want to encourage the church in Africa. For those who follow us on our ministry pages and our other platforms, you know, we are doing something in Africa. We are doing something in Africa and in the nations of the world. So just to encourage you that we continue praying for our countries. Now, yesterday, the Lord spoke to me something I would want us to hear, even concerning our continent, because we must be very alert. We must be very alert. And the Lord spoke to me and told me to pray and to warn those who are praying for this continent. We refuse imposed governments. We refuse imposed governments. That thing is there in the atmosphere, where some people want to impose, generally in Africa, some governments, and the Lord has requested us to pray against this. Now, even before we begin praying, because I've just released the word, I want to cancel that agenda of the enemy. In every country in Africa, we say no. There'll be no imposed government in this continent. We say no. If people are supposed to go for elections, they will go for elections, and they are going to choose. They are going to elect the leaders that they really want for their lives. So in Africa, in the atmosphere, even on this airwave, I cancel every agenda of the enemy against the destiny of this continent. And I refuse any imposed government. I refuse any imposed government in this continent in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I refuse that, because we have the power and authority. About 2 weeks ago, the Lord spoke to me and He told me, daughter, you don't have, sometimes you don't have to do so many things. I've given you the power and authority to decree and to declare. And so this morning, I want to decree and declare there will be no imposed government in this continent in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for your word. Thank you, Father, for your word. Thank you, Father, for your church. Thank you for preparing us this particular moment, so that you can hear what you have in store for us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for my life. life. Thank you, Father. We hide our lives in your favor. We hide our lives under the shadow of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, because the canopy of your grace is sufficient for us, and we give you the glory for that. Amen. I love you so much. Thank you for being there. Thank you for watching. Thank you for encouragement. Oh my God, thank you even for my Nicodemus type of friends who watch, and when the time comes, they reach out. Thank you. I've realized there are so many people who secretly, you know, or privately just watch and listen, but they don't comment, they don't say anything. And I thank God for that, because when the time comes, man, that's why I've requested that those who are ministering, the servants of God, let us be faithful to the call, even on these social media platforms, because when the time comes, these people begin looking for you because they have consistently seen you have been, you know, also consistent, and they are able to follow up and to know that you are true. They are able to know who is true and who is not true. So let us be faithful. Let us be faithful even on these social media platforms in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, I want to speak about what the Lord spoke to me yesterday, and those for those who attended our Friday prophetic prayers, I shared a bit of this, and I want to release now the whole word. I requested everybody to tune in and to hear the whole word, because you have been given a little time to minister to the church, you know, even on the ground, so we cannot have all the activities together and release the word, you know, all of it at the same time. The Lord spoke to me yesterday, and he said the church has been operating, you know, in with him, and in him we have been operating like strangers. But the Lord spoke to me yesterday, and he told me, daughter, I want you to cultivate, I want the church to cultivate that personal friendship with me. I want them to cultivate. So I'll be talking about cultivating, you know, I'll be telling us, cultivate personal friendship with God, because that is what now he is asking from us. He is our Father, hallelujah, and he really desires, you know, he's our Father, and he really desires that we deal with him as a friend. God desires that we deal with him as a friend, hallelujah. I'll be telling you, you know, what a friend is. Amen. Now, God said to me yesterday, you know, he was just reminding me that he loves us. He loves us with an everlasting love. And his is not an on and off relationship. God is not an on and off friend. He is not an on and off friend. He is a permanent, his and us, you know, our relationship with him is a permanent relationship that is geared towards our eternity. Hallelujah. He created us with a reason. And, you know, he told me yesterday that mine is not an on and off relationship or kind of a fellowship. It is an all time, hallelujah, in and out of season. And he said, mine is authentic, hallelujah. I am a father, hallelujah. Mine is an honor. It's not an honor of. It is something authentic that is geared to, you know, to being there for you. It is an all-out thing. And it is an all-time, an all-season kind of a fellowship in the name of Jesus. Now, the Lord spoke to me and told me, that's why I gave my only, you know, he gave his only begotten son. And I have always said, even if you are the only sinner in the world or human being on the on this face earth, God would have still said, he would have still given up, you know, his only begotten son, and he paid for our debts on the cross with his own body. Hallelujah. It was not something very good. It was, the Bible says, for God so loved, he did that because of love. Hallelujah. So he does not want us to deal with him as if, you know, as if he's a dictator. You know, when we were growing up, we were given a notion as if God was an, you know, a very old man. You know, we grew up with some of these things in our mind, you know, that kind of a picture you are seeing, as if God is a very old man seated somewhere very high, hallelujah, and you cannot reach him, you know. And some of us who are taught, you want to reach God, you must do a lot of fasting, you must do a lot of praying, and I've always told, you must do a lot of sowing of seeds. I've always told my children and my children in the Lord and my physical children, that you know, when I'm accessible, you know, they can reach me, you know, I'm with my children in my house, I'm, you know, both my my children in the Lord, they can easily access me, because what, we are friends, we are reachable. Hallelujah. They don't have to labor. Other strangers may labor making phone calls and all those things, but your children will just reach you. And I've always told people, if your children are supposed to go to school, they don't have to fast and pray. They'll just go. You know, as a father, you know, that is your personal responsibility, that your children should be sheltered, they should be fed, they should be dressed. Hallelujah. They should have a good life. You know, that is it. When somebody is supposed to be in school, that is your responsibility as a responsible father, to have them put in school. Hallelujah. So they don't have to labor so much. They don't have to labor so much. So that's what the Lord is saying. There is a lot of labor. There is a lot of vain labor. There is a lot of vain labor because of the way God was reflected to us. Hallelujah. But now this time he's saying, I am your friend. Cultivate that fellowship. Cultivate for that, you know, for that relationship. I am your friend. I am very near. I'm a nearby God. Hallelujah. You know, I'm not just a God who is far off. I'm a nearby God. I am omnipresent. Hallelujah. I'm an all-time God. Anytime you can reach me. Hallelujah. He's telling the children of Israel, I am the God, your God. I do not sleep on Sabbath. I'm the one who watches over you. You know, the Bible says the God who watches over Israel, he does not sleep on Sabbath. Even when you are deep in your sleep, even when you are deeper in things you cannot understand in your life, he's still watching. He's still there. Hallelujah. So he can easily be reached by you. Amen. And, you know, I love what the Bible says. In the book of John 15 and verse 13, you know, the Bible is saying, greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. That God caused the Son to lay his life for our sake as his friends. Hallelujah. That is the greatest sacrifice somebody can ever do, you know, for you. Now God is showing us, because of this great love, you know, the greater love, you know, it is so great if we can know the magnitude. And that's what the Lord is desiring, that we know the magnitude. You know, we get hold of this magnitude, why Jesus died. He did not just die. Thank you, Millicent, for coming on board. He did not just die. Jesus died for a cause. He did not just go. He did not just give up his breath on the cross. He did not just go through the pain. Hallelujah. The Bible is showing me it is because of that great love that God had for us. John 15 verse 13. Hallelujah. That he gave, you know, and the Bible is saying he did this because of his friends. We are his friends. Hallelujah. You know, the love our Father has towards each one of us, it is so tangible. It is so tangible and cannot be measured by anything. You cannot measure the love of God. Hallelujah. That's why we sing some of these Sunday school songs and we say, it is too deep, hallelujah, that you cannot get over it. It is too high. It is too wide. The love of God is too wide. Hallelujah. And that means it is touching all out in our lives. Hallelujah. Amen. His love is so steadfast. You know, it is very consistent. Hallelujah. And I want somebody to know this morning that God has not love you because of the things you do. He does not love you because of the things you do. Hallelujah. Oh my God of all glory. Our children are our children. For those who are married and you have children, your children are your children. Hallelujah. Whether they pass their exams, they're your children. That one will not change. Hallelujah. Whether they do what, that one will not change. They are your children in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now in him, the Bible shows me there is no shadow of a variation. There's no favoritism in God. Hallelujah. He loves us equally. He loves us equally. Hallelujah. In him there is no shadow of variation. No, God is not like a human being. Hallelujah. That when I sing so well, he's going to show us more favor than others. No, God is very steadfast. Hallelujah. In him there is no favoritism. Hallelujah. Now, he is our own friend, and I want you to own that and say, God is my own friend. There's a song we sing, what a friend we have in Jesus, you know. He is our own friend. It is not about our things or our doings. It's about the finished work that Jesus did on the cross. Hallelujah. That has brought that friendship very close to us, you know. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Now, I want to show you the description of a friend very fast. I'm going to be very fast because I came online to release the word of God. Now, the word of the rhema word of the Lord this morning is that you cultivate that personal friendship. Cultivate for it. Cultivate it, you know, and yearn for it, desire for it. Hallelujah. You know, a friend, I have one, two, or three very close friends in my life, and they can wake me up at any time. I can ignore other calls, but this particular one I cannot ignore. Even if I'm busy, I'll just say, I'll just take the phone and say, I am busy. Hallelujah. There are some calls, even if it is at 2 a.m. at night, you will pick it. Hallelujah. There are some things you can ignore others, but there are some people in your life that you have to attend to no matter what, and they know no matter what. When I call this woman of God, no matter what, she's gone to attend to these. You know, my dad in the Lord, my God, even if he calls me and I have not even taken a shower and he says, daughter, come here. You see the way I learn. Hallelujah. I learn. Hallelujah. Just come. If anytime dad calls, even if it is at whatever time, you'll find me there. You know, you'll find me there. That is it. You know, that's the kind of a thing, you know. God is saying, I am reachable. I'm accessible. Hallelujah. I'm not too far. The Bible says God is spirit. I'm about to show you some of these things, even as we come to the close of this sermon this morning, by the grace of God. So God is saying, you know, we were shown as if God is too far. My brethren, God is saying, I'm not too far. I'm there. I mean, by the way, God indwells us by the power of His Holy Spirit. We saw some of these scriptures in the past sermons we have done on this platform. You know, God is not too far. He's in us. He dwells us. You know, those days, Jesus is telling Aurama Hando Robozie. Jesus is telling the Samaritan woman, a time is coming. Hallelujah. It will not be about those physical mountains. It will not be about those buildings. That's why I've always been telling people, those people who say that the church was cross, church can never be cross. Church is a seed of God. A seed of God cannot be cross. A seed of God cannot be terminated. A seed of God cannot die. A seed of God cannot be hijacked. Are you hearing me, somebody? Church is a seed of God. It is the body of His Son. It cannot be crossed. Hallelujah. The buildings can be shut, but the church was still very active. And I'm telling you the truth. Watch the space. Now, I spoke and said in the month of March, the Lord spoke to me and He said, daughter, I'm about to take the church through a sieving season. You know, a sieving season where God was going to sieve for the sake of the church of Jesus Christ, and whatever was not supposed to be in the body is about to go down. Hallelujah. And whatever is going to remain here are the remnants of God's people. Hallelujah. And that's why you realize, even this time we are about to see, oh my God, we are about to see after this, you know, after this operation, we are about to see in nations, my God, the true priesthood. We are about to see a breakout of revival, because even when people could not travel from here to there, my God of all glory, we prayed, we continued in prayer. Actually, it was sweeter. Oh my God, there has broken forth such a revival in prayer, in loving the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh my God, individually, even when we could not gather in masses, oh my God, I have never failed to go to worship God. Oh my God, even a single day, I have never failed to step in the house of my Father, even a single day, because I don't know, there is no one, don't go anywhere. We remained there by the grace of God, because, well, let me tell you the truth. It is not about masses. It is about that personal relationship. It's about how you're connected with God. Don't talk about the God of so and so. I want you now to get hold of Him as your God. That's why Daniel is saying, those who know their God, you must know Him on a personal level. You must know Him on a very, very personal level. And the Lord is going to be glorified in your life, where you can reach God. I've always said, my God of all glory. Oh my God, I wake up in the morning and I tell God, Father, I need to make my hair. And just without even kneeling, without shouting, I go to my wardrobe and I tell God, my Father, you can see. I'm just talking to Him. Father, you can see me and you. These clothes are now very old. God, change this wardrobe for. Can we change this wardrobe, Lord? Hallelujah. Where I sit and tell God, Father, I need even milk. Hallelujah. Father, today I want, oh my God, I want to eat this. You know, I'm craving for one, two, three things, Daddy. And we are talking. talking, without shouting or nothing. I sit down in where I'm seated in my dining area, and I'm telling God, Father, one, two, three things. I'm not even shouting, my God of all glory. And I enter my rest. Hallelujah. Just like the way my son would come to me and tell me, Mommy, I don't have a pencil. I'm going to school, and the teacher said one, two, three things. And he has dropped the message to me, and he has gone. As a good mother, I'll act on that, because that is my responsibility. Now, the same case applies to our Father. Learn how to be afraid to Him. The Lord is saying to the church, cultivate for that friendship, cultivate for that kind of a fellowship, cultivate for that kind of a relationship. Hallelujah. Where you can, oh my God, even at night, my God, and I'm requesting the church, my Jehovah, when you sort your things out with God, as Esther and Mordecai, they are going to tell you, when you sort your matters with God, He knows how He's going to distribute, you know, such burdens, your burden in the hearts of people, my Jehovah God, and they are going to be woken up. That's why God can confidently tell Elijah, go to Zelophehad, I have commanded a widow, not even a rich person, not an officer in the government of their day, but I've commanded a widow. Why? Because God is a friend. When you walk with Him in His ways, my God, when you desire to know Him, when you desire to walk with Him, my Jehovah, even little things matter. Oh my God. That's why Jesus is saying, let the heavy laden. Now, these heavy laden are not people in the world. These are people in the church. These are believers in Jesus Christ. Them that are heavy laden. The Bible says, let them come to me and I will give them rest. Hallelujah. The Bible says, cast your cares unto me because I care. Thank you, my prophet from Ghana, Damien. God bless you. Now, the Lord is saying, cast your cares unto me. Now, let me surprise you, my brethren, even for those who are in marriages. I want to surprise you today. I've always, and parents who are born again, these are the things I have taught my children. I have taught them from their small age, when they were very little. Don't dash to me asking me for things. Bow down and ask God. If you need a handkerchief, go down, bow down on your bed and tell God, Father, I need a handkerchief. Provide for mommy. So when I go to her, she will have it. Those are the things. So anybody who come to me, I'll ask them, did you pray? And sorry. My daughter would want to make her hair. And I'm like, daughter, have you asked God? Have you talked to your father? He is your father. Have you spoken to him? Because that is how, that is the formula of where we begin. Hallelujah. So bring God close. God wants us to know that he is close. Can servants of Orikai and Orobozia, servants of God, can we bring God close to the people? Can we bring him in their hearts so that they don't keep on waking us up? My God, the Bible says we have been given the power, not only the servants of God, every believer, you have the power and authority over all the unclean spirit. That means when you are attacked anywhere, you don't have to look for a phone and look for a man of God. Hallelujah. You can cast out demons. Every believer, you can cast out demons. That's the power we have. The Bible says our kingdom is not a kingdom of word, but a kingdom of power. You have the power. Every believer has the power and authority over the unclean spirit. Hallelujah. You can address cancer. You can resurrect the dead. Every believer can resurrect the dead. The name can walk. My God, in your presence, you can just say, in the name of Jesus, I command you to walk. Hallelujah. That is it. That is God for you. Hallelujah. So he wants us to remain our friend, and he wants us to have that knowledge that he is our friend. Have that knowledge as a child of God that God is a friend. He's a father. He's a friend. And he's very attentive. He sees what other people cannot see in your life. He knows. He can search even your heart by the power of his Holy Spirit. He can search your heart. He knows everything about you. You know, David is saying, even when I went under my bed, he's still there because his presence is all over. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs that the eyes of God revolve all over the world. You know, he looks at the sons of God, and my God, testing those who are good and those who are bad. He knows. You cannot hide anything from him. That's why I'm saying, let us not just sing, I surrender. May you live a surrendered life. Can you know, my brethren, even what you think? Anytime you sit down and you are thinking over something, oh my God, that's why some of us have refused to be stressed. Initially, we used to suffer some of these things. Hallelujah. And that's why Jesus is saying, you know, take my yoke. It is right. Hallelujah. You know, the commands of God are not cumbersome. Salvation is so sweet, and the things of God are very easy because they are not burdens. Hallelujah. Things of God are not burdensome. Hallelujah. Because the Spirit of God is already in us and is able to tell us what to do and how to do it. Give us a formula at whatever time in the name of Jesus. So Jesus is telling this woman, the Spirit of God is reminding me to finish this. Jesus is telling this woman at the well, the Samaritan woman, you know, you people worship what you don't know, but as we worship what you know. And Jesus is telling this woman, a time is coming. Don't tell me about the well of Jacob. Don't tell me about how big you have put up a big and magnificent building for God. Don't tell me about all those things. Hallelujah. Tell me about your relationship with God. That is what matters. It's not about all those buildings. It is not about those physical buildings. It is about your walk in the Lord, your walk in the faith, your walk in the Spirit. That is what will control your physical being in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So who is afraid? Afraid is a person or someone you know well and like. You know, someone you know well. Hallelujah. That's why I say, my God, I know what my father can say. Rama handolobozia. That is it. My brethren, even if somebody came prophesying, closing one of their eyes and shouting and doing their kadabra and all of you, my Jehovah, I don't have to struggle to test the spirit. Even on TV, I'll just look and say, this is not in our kingdom. We don't have to, we are not struggling with these things. We are not struggling with them because in us, God indwells us. Our bodies are his temples. Hallelujah. These bodies are God's dwelling place. Hallelujah. We are the carriers of his presence. That's where we are collecting some of these songs. Like now in my country, man of God from Ghana, allow me to say something in our language. You know, at nakaribisha uwepo wa Mungu. You know, I'm welcoming the presence of God. Well, you know, I enter in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, you are the carrier of the presence of God. Our bodies are the temples of God. God indwells us. Hallelujah. God is in us. The Bible says that Jesus is in us, the hope of glory. You know, God has deposited his Spirit in us. Hallelujah. And that is why we are able to worship him in truth and in spirit. Hallelujah. That's why we are able to connect with him. So we don't enter in his presence. We are the carrier of his presence. We don't enter in his presence. We are the carrier. So when we gather in the presence of worship where we are gathering as carriers. We are all of us carrying. And that's why you should cultivate. Thank you, my bishop from Mauritius. I honor you people. I love you. Thank you. That's why you should cultivate for your every moment. You should cultivate for your for your well-being with your father. You know, stay maintain that that relationship, maintain that fellowship, so that when we gather together, we shall be at a par. We shall be flowing from one source. Hallelujah. There shall be unity of purpose in the fellowship of brethren. Hallelujah. There shall be that unity of purpose. You know, we shall be so intertwined. So when I say it is in Kenya, somebody in Ghana, my prophet, is saying the same thing. Because what? We are in the same spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. So a friend, that is God for you. It's a person or someone you know. That's why Daniel is saying those who know their God. Now, desire to know your God. Desire to know his voice. Desire to know how his operations. Desire to know. And how do you get this? You get this in a place of prayer. Jesus is confidently saying, I only do what I see my father do. You know, imagine the father was in heaven and he's saying, what you are seeing me do down here is what my father is doing. Hallelujah. That's why I've always said, even the healings that Jesus effected when he was here on earth, anything he did, even resurrected the people he resurrected, that one was ordained of God. Healing that man at the pool of Bethesda, where there were so many invalid people, it was ordained of God. Hallelujah. That is what was being done in heaven. That's why when Jesus was teaching the disciples how to pray, he's telling them, let your will be done here on earth as it is being done in heaven. Hallelujah. Because our lives are controlled from where we are seated with Christ in heavenly places in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we don't just do things. You don't just handle your wife. You don't just handle your children. Our things are controlled from our kingdom. Hallelujah. Because we are representative of our kingdom here. I've always said we are ambassadors of Christ here. So when somebody wants to see Jesus, they should look at us. Hallelujah. Because we are the sons of God who are physically down here by the grace of God in Jesus' name. So know you are God on a personal level. know, afraid is somebody you know well. Hallelujah. Desire to know God well. Desire to know him. God has names. You know, Jehovah Jireh. Desire to have an encounter with the provision, that divine provision. Hallelujah. Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals. Hallelujah. El Shaddai, Shalom. Desire, hallelujah. Desire to know him on a very personal level in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, the other thing is that a friend is a person who has the same interests, hallelujah, and opinions as yourself, and he will help and support you. That person who has the same interest and opinions, hallelujah. Now, we are sons of God. The Bible says, as many as believed in him, they were given the power to become sons of God. So, we have already been grafted in. I love what the Bible says. Just as Isaac was a son of promise, we have also been grafted in there. So, any promise that God gave to our father of faith, Abraham, we are also partakers, hallelujah. So, that God is saying, that person who has the same interest with you, the same opinions with you, hallelujah. And this person will help you and support you when you need their help, when you need their support, they are there. Now, that is God for you. Church, that is God for you. So cultivate for that personal friendship. Cultivate for that personal friendship. My Jehovah, I tell you the truth. When I need my hair done and when I'm where I am, hallelujah, oh my God, I can never be stuck. I used to be stuck those days when I did not have, you know, I had not developed that personal relationship with God. But now, the Bible says that just shall live by faith. My Jehovah lead him. I'll just wake up and sit. Even if I'm walking, my Jehovah, even if I'm seated with no shouting, with nothing, and I will tell God, Father, you know, I open my fridge and say, Father, you know, we don't have milk. Father, can you see we don't have milk? That's how I talk. Father, can you see we don't have milk? Hallelujah. Father, can you see my hair needs to be made? Hallelujah. Father, can we make our nails today? You know, he's a friend. Hallelujah. And I want to surprise you. God, even what I desire. Father, you know, I was telling people, last Tuesday, I decided to eat something. And in my locality, I never found it. When I went to church, the same evening, somebody was commanded from the city center, do 1, 2, 3 things for my servant. And she came calling that whatever I desired, that is God for you. No, so when you, that is what happened to Esther. When you sort out your issues with God up here, hallelujah, then he will command down here for you. That's why I'm saying he's not too far. Learn how to walk with him, walk in him. It is all about him. Hallelujah. Cultivate for it, because God has your interest. We have the same interest. He's a father. I cannot have other interest against the destiny of my children. My children in the Lord, you know. My children, you know, my daughters and sons in the Lord. I love you so much. Anything you see me do, it's for your welfare. That is God for you. Anything he's going to do, that's why he even gave up our firstborn brother. The Bible calls him our firstborn brother, Jesus, to die a very painful death on the cross. Hallelujah. Because he loved us so much. Amen. Now, God has the same opinion with you. You are his son. Hallelujah. He's here to help. The Bible says he is our ever-present help. Even in times of trouble, when you don't have anybody to talk to, anybody, nobody can understand you. That is it. That is that. Now, if you look at people like Daniel, that is it. Hallelujah. A man can see lions in the den there, and they are throwing, the entire nation is gathered here, and they are throwing him down there. He's not calling for help. He's not even calling his mother. Oh my God. He's not calling, you know, pleading with the king and kneeling and pleading with the king. He says, my God, even down there in the den of Ramahandorobozia, even in the den of the lions, I have help down. Oh my God. Come on, somebody. Come on, church. Even in the den of the lion, amidst the trouble, I have my help already set. I have my help already there for me. Hallelujah. So I have nothing to fear. I have nothing to fear. God is here with me. That's why he says, even if you walk in the valley of the shadow of death, hallelujah, he is there. Even in the fires, you will not be burnt. We are seeing it clearly. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Even Jesus appears in the fire. Hallelujah. They were never burnt. That is God for you. Hallelujah. So it does not matter how the devil has fixed your destiny. Cultivate your friendship with God. That is the beginning of your victory. That is the beginning of your solution. Cultivate your friendship with God. Hallelujah. He is a father who is very near. And let me surprise you the truth. You know, there are some things that you go through, you know, in our lives, and you cannot even tell anybody. You even don't know what to say. I've been there before, my God of all glory, where you are just growing thin and growing thin because of the issues of life, but you don't know how to trust in your life. You even don't know what to say. say. Hallelujah, gladness. You even don't know what to say. But God, my Jehovah God, when you have cultivated that friendship with Him, He is able to, by the power of His Holy Spirit, He is able to search all things. The Bible says the Spirit of God searches all things. Hallelujah. Your emotions, your desires. If you know the things I tell God, my God of all glory, hallelujah. Even my own emotions, I'll speak to Him. I'll tell Him, Father, oh my God, this one needs to be sorted out, because God, Father, this one, two, three things, hallelujah, very deep things, hallelujah. One time I'll teach women some of these things, amen. Now listen to this. I'm looking at the synonym. I want to read for you. I want to read for you some of these things, because we need to know somebody you can contact. A friend is somebody you can contact at whatever time. Hallelujah. It's somebody you can reach to. It's somebody you can reach to at whatever time in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It's somebody, it's a companion. Hallelujah. It's somebody you have that intimate relationship. And that's what I've always been teaching the church. Develop intimate relationship with God. Hallelujah. It's a soulmate. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm looking at the synonym of this. It is an associate, a comrade. Hallelujah. You know, it's a buddy, whatever people call buddy, you know. Hallelujah. Now, there are so many synonyms about this. Amen. Now, a friend can never be an enemy. A friend cannot be an enemy in the name of Jesus. Now, I want us, I came to release the word of God for those who are joining up with us now. Man of God, my brother Dan Matthews, God bless you, welcome on board. Now listen to this. I want to let you know that God is speaking to the church. Many of us have been relating with God as if He's a stranger, as if He's too far. God is saying now, cultivate, I'm a friend, you know, cultivate that personal friendship with me, cultivate it. I'm not too far, I'm very near. God is a never-present help. He's very close. Don't, you know, sometimes, let me speak to you Pentecostals, not once, not twice, you know, the Lord would tell me, I enter in a hotel. Oh my God of all glory, you are somewhere and God tells you, go to a hotel, and here people don't shout. You enter in an office and the Lord tells you, I just brought you to make a prayer and to make a declaration, and people here don't shout. Hallelujah. God tells you, go to the toilet and kneel there, and you are very smart. You go to the toilet, hallelujah, and you flash and you are inside there. You have not even gone to relieve yourself. No, because praying is not about shouting. Praying is not about shouting. Mama, thank you, Eva. God bless you. Praying is not about shouting. Are you hearing me, church? Praying is not about many wordings. Many wordings cannot make your prayer effective. Hallelujah. Prayer can only be effective now depending on your relationship with the one who you are praying to. Hallelujah. Your relationship with God matters. So before you shout, before you make so many sentences, before you shed tears and all those things, begin by making Him your friend. Hallelujah. Begin by making God your friend. When that is done, now you can even comfortably just sit. Hallelujah. Just sit like the way you are sitting. You relax. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is telling me, when you make God your friend, you relax. Even when you are praying, you relax. Hallelujah. You just relax. You know, that's why Jesus is saying, Father, not my will. I have prayed, I have done, you know, even my sweat turned to be drops of blood. I have done all those. And then He says, why am I struggling with this thing? My Father knows this. He can see this. And Jesus owns up and He says, Father, it's not my will, but let your will be done. Hallelujah. Not my will anymore. I cannot struggle with this. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying, just relax. My children, relax. Hallelujah. I am your Father. I have your well-being in my heart. Oh my God, I came to give us, I called it a prophetic divine alignment breakfast on a Saturday in the morning. Hallelujah. Now the Lord is saying, just be aligned, prophetically be aligned. Be aligned just to know, enjoy the comfort in my presence. My presence indwells you. So enjoy that comfort. Relax. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to physically labor. The Spirit of God in you is able to do all those things. We will even give you the utterance. That's what, you know, everything about our walk of faith, my brethren, is so simplified. It's so simplified. That's what Jesus is saying. The commands of God are not cumbersome. Hallelujah. It's so simplified. You can just even sit in your car and tell the Lord, Father, My God, one time, let me give you this testimony. And my children are reasoning. Let me give you this testimony. One time, I didn't have money to fuel a car, and I was going somewhere to take to drop my daughter to school. And I was a father. Now I will fuel this car with what you've given me. And it was a long journey. And I would just go about 4 hours, you know, going and coming. It was about 6 hours. Hallelujah. So I needed a full tank plus. Now listen to this. I drove that car. I drove that car. Thank God. I requested my bishop, my dad, for a bigger car. So I drove his big car. And let me tell you the truth. I drove that car. And we got somewhere. I saw, my God, the tank was getting empty. And you know what I told my daughter? What I told the Spirit of God? I just spoke. And I told the Spirit of God, the Spirit of God, fuel this car. Do not ashamed me at the middle of the Lord, at the middle of the highway. We shall go where we are going. Now, whatever you want, if you want to give me money, you are going to give me money. And I'm relaxed. I'm on the road. I'm relaxed. And I just drove the car. And do you know, my daughter can testify to this. One day she's going to come online here and testify. We drove and we went. And I never even bothered about the tank anymore. We went. We went. My brethren, we went. Hallelujah. Because God is a father. God is a father. He is well acquainted with our desires, with our lives. Our lives are bare. So he's saying, don't deal with me as a stranger. That's why I've always said, God is not a fire brigade that you just dash to get these machines when the fire breaks out. Hallelujah. He is not an ambulance. He's not an ambulance. He wants you to, oh my God, if you know the way I feel, my God. You know, I feel so loved. You know, you may not like my nose. You know, you may not, because people will hate you for nothing. You may not like so many things about me. But let me tell you the truth. Nowadays, I don't care. From the time I cultivated for that fellowship with God, I feel so good. You know, I'm like, I feel as if I own everything here in the world. My God, I don't panic anymore. I don't panic anymore. There is no fear anymore. What somebody thinks about me. My God, even let me surprise you. I even don't have issues with my enemies. Because what? Let me surprise you. Because my father can see, even when they are conspiring, he can see them. He can hear even what I cannot hear. So me, and I have always said in my house, when I'm fasting, I will fast. When I'm eating, I will eat. Hallelujah. That is it. Hallelujah. Because, you know, oh my God, God is such a friend. Church, are you hearing me? Are you hearing me this morning? God, our Father, is such a friend. He is such a friend. He is such a friend who cannot fail you. You can try to call me, prophetess, and my phone will be off because maybe I'm praying. But 24/7, 365 days in a year, every year, every moment, you can access God. Hallelujah. You can access him. And it is free. There is no appointment. Hallelujah. You know, yesterday I was trying to look for somebody in this country. And you know, I couldn't get through. I got the number, yes, but I couldn't get through. Hallelujah. I sent a message. Thank God they responded back. Because there is a lot of protocol. There is a lot of protocol. Hallelujah. Even before you reach some of these people, my God of all glory. Hallelujah. But to God, there's no protocol. You can access him. So cultivate. Oh my God, where you can, oh my God of all glory, women, my God, for those who are not married, when you have nobody, when you have nobody to tell you I love you, I don't know what, now listen to this, I tell God, Father, here comes your princess, here comes your daughter, Lord God, here comes, you know, I pour out my heart, and I tell him, Daddy, 1, 2, 3 things. Hallelujah. Daddy, you know, I don't have a husband to give me money to make my hair. I have to look nice. Daddy, you know, I don't have a man around me, you know, to lean on. Hallelujah. Daddy, you have to pay my bills. Women, are you listening to this? I don't have to look for a man to call. I don't have a husband. So, Daddy, you know, that is me. Daddy, you know, my bills have to be paid. Hallelujah. My children must go to school. Daddy, you know, 1, 2, 3 things. That is... Hallelujah. Women, are you listening to this? So you don't have to look for a man and keep on saying, you know, I don't have a husband. So what? Hallelujah. He's your husband for now before he blesses us. So you take advantage. Actually, even when I get married, my husband has to know this. You know, that relationship between me and my father, that one is very intact. The same case applies when you get married and you are coming from your father. No, that one will never change. The same case applies to this. Now, for those who are in marriages, please, your husband is not Jehovah Jireh. God is. And before you bombard him with issues and needs, please cultivate your friendship with God, who is able to provide for him, for that husband, for him to be able to provide for you. Hallelujah. Stop summing your husband with words and nonsense. I call them nonsense women and attitudes. Hallelujah. Who said you cannot also make who said you cannot buy for your husband a suit? Does it mean that they have to do everything? No. They are also sons of God. You are also son of God. So you are operating from the same level of faith. Ah, thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying, cultivate. Oh my God of all glory. My God. From the time I got to this knowledge, my brethren, I am at rest. Hallelujah. Oh my God. You know, many other times you used to call people, you are calling people, you are getting frustrated because people are not helping you. Now your help is God. Your help is in him and he is your help. Hallelujah. And he is your father. So I want us to look at the characteristic of our main characteristic of this friend I'm calling God. The characteristic of generally even of a friend. Hallelujah. And I'm going to be very fast. Proverbs 17 and verse 17a. The Bible says, a friend laughs at all times. Hallelujah. That can only be God. Now, genuinely, in this world, human beings can be limited, but God will love you. My God, Rikayando Lobozia, he does not love you because you are feeling good, because today you are down, tomorrow you are up. Now, God will love you at all times. Hallelujah. Thank you, my brother Dan. That is God for us. Hallelujah. Oh, my God of all glory. When you don't have somebody to tell you, I love you, my God, know that your father is loving you at all times. Hallelujah. So don't grow thin that you don't have a husband or a wife to tell you, I love you. Now, love God. Hallelujah. Reciprocate his love. He has already loved you. Reciprocate that love. So afraid to know that somebody is your friend is because they will love you at all times. Hallelujah. When nobody can understand you and nobody can be there for you, a friend will always love you at all times. The Bible says in Proverbs 18 and verse 24, Hallelujah. Now, if you have a friend, now you are also supposed to be friendly. That's why I'm saying reciprocate. Hallelujah. The love of God in your life, reciprocate it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It is a two-way traffic in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, I love the part B of that. The Bible shows me in Proverbs 18 and verse 24b. Part B of that shows me that God is a friend who sticks closer to us than a brother. You know, somebody who are your blood brother, somebody, your sister, your brother, the people you know, you came out from the same womb. God is able to stick closer. That's why Jesus can confidently say, my mother and my brothers are these ones who are doing the will of my father. Hallelujah. That is God for you. Amen. That's why Jesus says, I did not come to bring peace. I came to bring sword. I came to separate. I came to bring separation. The sword is the word of God. Hallelujah. The word of God is able to bring a demarcation, even in the family setup. Hallelujah. Between my brothers and my sisters, if they are not walking light, then I don't belong. Hallelujah. Now, if they are using their traditions, then I don't belong. There is a separation. Amen. Proverbs 27 verse 6, the Bible says, hallelujah. Now, faithful chastens. Now, any friend, you know, I love that openness. An open rebuke from a friend is better. And that's why I always say, just tell me the truth. I have friends who are watching here and they are my friends even from other countries. Somebody who do even look at your hair doing, somebody who man of God, that one is not for you. We have even never met physically, but somebody will tell you, I love that. And Church of Jesus Christ, let us allow God, you know, let us allow him to chasten us. The Bible says he chastens them that he loves. Let us allow him. Hallelujah. Not everything patting your shoulders and telling you, No, when you go wrong, allow him. Just like the way we deal with other relationships. When I do wrong, I have friends who can tell you, woman of God, properly facing me and telling me 1, 2, 3 things. Without covering things up. That is God for you. Hallelujah. He faithfully rebukes and chastens. Hallelujah. Now listen to this. God will do this. He's not going to come down physically, but we have the scriptures. We have the word of God. And the Bible says, I want to give the scriptures. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 16. The Bible says all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction. That's why I'm telling the church, don't just be dashing for the scriptures. Hallelujah. That are saying you're going to encounter a miracle. That are saying I don't know what. Even where you are
life is being corrected. You know, in this walk of faith, we are being refined to attain, you know, that level, you know, of sonship, of sonship, because we are sons of God. Hallelujah. Where we fit in well, we don't struggle with God. We are able to flow in the Spirit by the grace of God in Jesus' name, for reproof, for correction, for instruction, and in righteousness. Hallelujah. That is the scripture. You know, that is the word of God for you. The scriptures, this is the word of God. And we know Jesus Christ is the word of God. And now he's already in us. Hallelujah. The hope of glory. Amen. The Bible says in John 15, verse 14 and verse 15. Hallelujah. The Bible says, you are my friends if you do whatever I command you. Hallelujah. Jesus is telling the disciples, you are my friends. Hallelujah. If you do whatever I command you. Now, our qualification of being a friend to God is that we obey. We obey. We obey. Church of Jesus Christ, before you shout, before you fast again, just sit down and check your life, because this is where the friendship is being cultivated. Hallelujah. From obeying the commands of the Lord, obeying the scriptures, obeying, it could be also the remas, obeying. Obedience is key. The Bible says obedience is better than a sacrifice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God of all glory, obedience is a key. Are you obeying? Have you obeyed the whole word, not just a part that is favoring you? Hallelujah. For the people who are killing enemies, killing them by fire, by thunder, that is not scriptural. In the New Testament, hallelujah, I know somebody is about to read for you the word of God in the book of Exodus, that we should not suffer a witch leaf. But listen to this. Jesus is saying, hallelujah, pray for those who persecute you. I love what the Bible says in the book of Psalms, hallelujah, that God will lay a table for you in the presence of your enemies. So you don't want the table to be laid for you when you kill the enemies, when they all die, then you don't need a table. You don't want to enjoy the overflow of your cup. Hallelujah. So let them live. Let people live. Stop killing them. By the way, there's no scripture backup. There is nowhere Jesus, you know, one of the disciples of Jesus, they were doing ministry with Jesus. And, one time they told him, can we call fire? Hallelujah. And burn these people. And Jesus said, we are not called for this. We have not been called to go destroying the lives of mankind. Hallelujah. That is not our operation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now let us emulate Jesus. That's why I'm saying, you know, when you walk with God, the Spirit of God within you, because there is a deposit of God in you by his Spirit. Hallelujah. As a son of God, he'll be showing you how to behave, how to handle things. You not be puffed up when now they say, now we are selling stickers, and these stickers, when you put them beside your bed and you're not married, hallelujah, we are sticker with the photo of a man of God, it will be speaking to you in your bed. Seriously, that is nonsense. Hallelujah. Oh my, we don't need all this nonsense. A character with a photo of a man of God, you know, you keep it everywhere, the stickers everywhere, in the car, everywhere. No, this is nonsense. You don't need the presence of the man of God in your life, even in your bedroom. You need the presence of your Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A man of God, we are limited, but there is what God can do. That, oh my God, there is a portion of God which is a major portion about our whole being. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. That's why I'm requesting the servants of God. Can we stop drawing men to ourselves? Hallelujah. Can we draw men to Jesus? Can we direct when they come? Can we draw them to him? Because it's all about him. Salvation is all about him. Hallelujah. Let us not gather people to us. Let us not gather people. Let us not own that people. That's why I say church is not a member, a club. I know, a membership club. Hallelujah. It's not a membership club. Hallelujah. Where we have our own members. You don't have your members. We are all members of the body of Jesus Christ, including us prophets. We are all members of the body of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So let us direct people. Let us direct people to the owner of the church. That is Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, requirement of friendship, I'm going to be very fast. Number one, if you're writing, you can write down. This is download from the Spirit of God. Now, requirement of friendship. Now, it requires acquaintance. It requires acquaintance. Hallelujah. Now, that comes from regular fellowship. Hallelujah. You cannot know somebody unless you regularly fellowship with them. Hallelujah. You can fellowship over a cup of tea. You can fellowship over prayer. Hallelujah. Because I love it when people connect in the Spirit. I have people in my life, even who are not in my country, but we pray. We wake up and say, can we pray for 2 hours? Hallelujah. Can we pray? We are not even together, so nobody is monitoring whether you are doing it. faith. But because we are friends, we are able to flow. And at the end of the prayer, we are able to connect. This is what the Lord is saying, and we can all agree and confirm it. Hallelujah. So now, requirement of friendship, it requires that complete acquaintance. Hallelujah. Where you know that person in and out, where you know that person. Hallelujah. That's why I say, my God of all glory, even if they say God has said, and that is it. Even if somebody came to me and say, woman of God, the Lord is saying, drink water, and I have prophets who are watching me here today, it will be a confirmation. Because what? I am not a stranger in the presence of my Father. I know Him. I know Him. I know what He can say concerning me, and I know what He cannot say. So I am not a stranger. I am not a stranger. I am not a stranger. Hallelujah. So the other thing is communication. Communication. Speak out. Now, communication is a two-way. Speak out and listen. Speak out. Church, are you hearing me? Don't just sit down. Today, sit down and listen. Ask God, Father, speak to me. Speak to me. Hallelujah. Speak to me. Allow Him to speak. Many other times we just go and speak to God. This friendship is a two-way relationship. Allow God to speak to you. Hallelujah. So requirement of friendship is a complete acquaintance. The other thing is communication. Listen. Don't always speak. Don't always shout. Listen. Hallelujah. The other thing is sacrifice. A friend would sacrifice anything. Thank you, my daughter Octavia from South Africa. A friend will sacrifice anything. They will go out of their way to make sure you are comfortable, to make sure you are sorted out. Hallelujah. To make sure they are praying out for your destiny. To make sure, oh my God of all glory. Hallelujah. That is God for you. So He's saying, cultivate for this. Don't deal with me as if I'm too far. Deal with me as if I'm here, as if I'm in your life, because that is where He is. God is already in our lives. He's already in us. My God, there is a deposit of God, hallelujah, by the power of His Holy Spirit in our lives. Hallelujah. So we are not going to look for God. We are not going to look for His presence. And I began by correcting something. The songs we are saying that we draw to your presence. We are the carriers of the presence of God. So where are we drawing to His presence? We are the carriers of His presence. Hallelujah. Oh my God. So it's when we gather together, we just pour ourselves out and just worship Him and love Him. We are not drawing to His presence. Hallelujah. Those buildings are not the carriers of the presence of God. We are the carriers of the presence of God. Hallelujah. So when we gather together, we are gathering together for this corporate worship, because we are carriers of the presence of God. So let us go direct to worship. Hallelujah. Let us go direct to. That's why when Jesus is teaching the disciples how to pray, He never began by saying, we are drawing near to your presence, Rama handle or whatever. He's going direct to the worship. He's saying, Father, our Father who is at in heaven, hallowed. We are the carriers of your presence. So we come to you to worship. Hallelujah. We come to honor you. We come to adore you. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 5. The Bible is showing me that God has loved us. We are His friends. Let us therefore give back to Him. Hallelujah. You shall love. The Bible says you shall love. God is speaking to the children of Israel. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. That is it, my brethren. Hallelujah. He is already indwelling us. So our work is to reciprocate this. Let us love Him with our hearts. Hallelujah. Because from the abundance, you know, our hearts, the Bible says the heart of a man is so deceitful. Let us love Him with our souls. Let us love Him with our strength. Hallelujah. And when you love God with your strength, you have no issues. The people who say about tithe, it is undebatable. Giving God even your resources, it's undebatable. You don't struggle. My God, you don't struggle with your time with God. You don't struggle. You're not even pushed to be in the place of the central worship on time. You're not even pushed by anybody to give you a tithe, to give your offering. No, things just flow. Hallelujah. Because you have cultivated that and you have reciprocated back the love of God in your life in Jesus' name. So very fast, I want us to get some examples. My time is up. I want us to get some examples, but I have to finish this. Hallelujah. I want us to get some examples. The Bible says in the book of Exodus chapter 33 and verse 11, Verse A of that, the Bible says, so the Lord spoke to Moses face to face as a man speaks to his friend. Now you cannot fear. That's what I'm saying for Moses. Exodus 33, that is God for you. The same today, yesterday, and forevermore. You know, God, the way you can speak to me face to face without any fear, that is the way God desired. If he did it to Moses, my God, this is what I have been desiring. Father, sit here. My God, Father, sit here. Oh my God, today we are having dinner. Father, sit here. And I pull a seat and I tell him, Father, sit here. Can we have a talk, Daddy? Can we talk? Can we talk? I love, there's a girl of one of my daughters in one of the countries. You know, she's like, why are you singing this song? Jesus has told me to sing for him this song. Why are you praying this game? Jesus has told me to pray for him this game. I love it like that. A very small girl. Now, that is it. Now, do everything. That's why Paul is saying, anything you do, either in words or in deeds, you do it unto him. Cultivate that friendship. Cultivate that friendship where you can face him at whatever time. Hallelujah. And where he can also rebuke you. You know, he can, oh my God, not once, not twice. I want to open my mouth and I want to say something. You hear that inner voice telling you, shut up. Shut up. Hallelujah. And you withdraw, you call down because you know that is the voice of my Father. Hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, somebody has invited you somewhere and my God, the last minute your father tells me, that is not, daughter, that is not my meeting. And if it is not my meeting, it is not your meeting. You take your phone. I have disappointed so many. Hallelujah. And the Lord tells me, don't, just call them. Sometimes even you don't have to explain, you just keep quiet because the Father has not told you to explain. That's why the Bible says many times Jesus will just withdraw. You have nothing to explain to anybody because nobody will understand you. That is God for you because he has your welfare in his heart in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Luke 11, 5 and 8, the Bible is talking about a story where a friend, Jesus was giving an example that a friend went at midnight. He got afraid, so he went at midnight to another friend's house and he's knocking and he persisted. You know, he was requesting for bread. The friend refused to open, but because of the way he persisted, this friend opened and gave him bread. That is God for you. At whatever time he can attend. So the Lord is speaking about, let us persist. Don't just love him today and tomorrow you don't love him. Let there be persistency in this issue. Be consistent. Hallelujah. Don't be on and off. Let your relationship with God not be on and off. Be consistent. Be persistent. That is our prophetic alignment message from the Lord this weekend. Hallelujah. Before you go for the fellowship tomorrow or whatever time, just make sure you are afraid. Don't just shout. Don't just rebel. Make sure you have that friendship with God. And it's going to be very easy for you. You're going to enjoy salvation. Hallelujah. Now, God will always attend to our requests if they are according to his will. Hallelujah. If everything about us is flowing according to his purpose, the Bible says he knows the end from the beginning and his counsel will stand. His purposes will stand concerning our lives, his purposes. So that's why Jesus is saying, not my will, let your will be done. Mary is owning up and saying, Father, you know, that's what you have said. That is what, Father, you have decided. Let it be done. It made it happen to me. I'm here, your maid servant. Hallelujah. That is God for you. Amen. Now, God will always grant our desires. That's what the Bible says. The desires of a righteous man will never be cut off. But when there is that friendship, hallelujah, not a friend who is so many kilometers away, but when they need their desires granted, they come closer. No, remain there. And let me surprise you, Abraham knew when Isaac was supposed to get married. Isaac did not know. Even he had not even prayed or fasted about it. The father knew. That is God for you. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 6 that he then learned after these things, but your father knows that you need them. That is God for you. Hallelujah. So he says, seek my kingdom first and my righteousness. All other things I'm going to add. Nitaongeza. Hallelujah. My people in Kenya, God will add. Hallelujah. So before you do anything this weekend, that's why God has sent me this ceremony. Just sit back and tell God, Father, please, I want to become your friend. Can we be friends, Daddy? Can we be friends? Hallelujah. Where I can, you know, my God, I tell God anything. You know, when I'm talking anything, anybody in the spirit will understand this. Even when I'm not emotionally, when I need, you know, to be, Father, 1, 2, 3 things. Hallelujah. And God is very faithful in the name of Jesus. We see the story of Lazarus in the book of John 11. Hallelujah. Verse 3, you know, we are seeing Jesus, you know, the sisters of Lazarus are telling Jesus, the one we love is sick. Hallelujah. They report the one who you love is sick. The Bible shows me in verse 11, Jesus is telling the disciples, let us go. Hallelujah. Our friend Lazarus is sleeping. He's asleep. Let us go and wake him up. Hallelujah. Now, verse 36, we see, you know, the Jews that had gathered to mourn with this family, you see, the Bible says that verse 35, Jesus wept. So they are looking at Jesus and they are like, see how he loved him. Hallelujah. Even people can testify how he loved him. The mourners who are still waiting there to eat whatever has been left. Hallelujah. African custom. They eat everything and they leave you poor because of value. Now listen to this. They concluded, see how he loved him. Now that is it, my brethren. Now I have always noted something by the power of the Holy Spirit, that Jesus went so many kilometers. He passed so many homes. Now I want to let you know, it is not only Lazarus that was dead that time. There were so many dead men and dead people, but Jesus made his way when it was time to go and resurrect his friend, wake him up. Actually, he did not talk about death. He made his way. He passed so many homes. He passed so many families. He passed so many, maybe even there were people who were burying that particular moment he was passing by, but he was just directed. He went direct to sort out the issue of his friend. That is God for you. Hallelujah. That is God for you. Are you hearing me, church? So when you are consistently there, now that's why the Bible says, how quickly will God serve justice to those who seek him day and night? You know, they are consistent. They are not just going when they need the money. When they get it and they get those tenders and when they get married, you know, God, give me a marriage. Give me a wife. Give me a husband. And when you get the person, you no longer now love God anymore. Now listen to this. The Bible says the blessings of God are the denial. So that means they should not remove you from the presence of your father. They should not bring any disconnection. Actually, if a man came to my life, he should draw me near. Nearer to God, not driving me away. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me, sisters who are not married? Now, be very careful. Make sure your relationship with your father is okay, so you are able to discern. For those who are in business, my God, let those businesses not get you out of the presence of your father. Let nothing come in between you and your father. God should be your first priority. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Abraham, James chapter 2. And verse 23, hallelujah. It is reminding us that Abraham believed in God and it was accounted for him for righteousness. Hallelujah. Because this man was afraid of God. It was accounted to him. My God, the Bible says, you know, shows me, you know, he was called afraid of God because he believed in God and it was even accounted to him for righteousness. Hallelujah. Because of believing God, because Abraham, our father of faith, could not hold anything, even his own. Waited for this boy for so long. I've waited for the fulfillment of this prophecy for so long. My God of all glory, I cannot hold it anymore. I know me and this boy, we belong to God. That is my God. That can only be afraid. Hallelujah. Who, when after you have even given them something, oh my God, and then they release it, that can only be God. Hallelujah. That's why some of us, we have no issues. God tells me, clear your house, I'll clear it. Clear wardrobe, I'll clear it. And I even don't ask him, now, when will you give me other clothes? I just leave it there. He's a father. Hallelujah. Now, listen to this. King Jehoshaphat, in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 20 and verse 7, they were faced by three enemies. Three nations had risen against the children of God. So King Jehoshaphat is making a prayer. And he's reminding God amidst the enemies. He is reminding God about the covenant and the promises he made to his friend Abraham. Hallelujah. Jehoshaphat was able to face God and remind him what he had promised Abraham. Hallelujah. And Jehoshaphat was well aware that if you promised our father of faith Abraham this, then even in the midst of these enemies that are facing us today, we have the victory. We are partakers of this. That which you promised your friend Abraham, we are partakers of this. Now, I want the church to know, the Lord is saying, don't just come to me when you need me. Come to me because we are friends. Remain in me. That's what the Bible says in John chapter 15. Hallelujah. Our Father, oh my, let me read the scriptures because I'm hearing those scriptures. Just one sentence. Let me read the scriptures. I'm hearing that portion of the scripture in my spirit. Let me just read for you very fast. Hallelujah. John 15. I'm hearing the scripture. I'll read for you the first part of it. The Bible says, I had not planned for this. vine and my Father is a vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes. Hallelujah. Are you seeing this, church? That it may bear more fruit. So allow the Lord to chasten you. Allow the Lord to rebuke you. By the scriptures are there to rebuke, to correct, hallelujah, to instruct. Hallelujah. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. Abide in me. I love that portion of the scripture. Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit in itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. Are you hearing me, church? I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. Hallelujah. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather. That is what we are seeing. A lot of people have withered because they are not abiding. They are on and off. So when you cut yourself off, the devil is able to hit you like the prodigal son there. You suffer so many things. So by the time you reconnect to yourself, you have nothing. You are so down. You are so wounded. Hallelujah. But nevertheless, pick up your broken pieces and cultivate your friendship with God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, God indwells us by the power of his spirit. Jesus is already in us, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. We are the dwelling place of God. Our bodies are the temples of God. So we are not looking for God. He's already in us. Hallelujah. His presence is already in us. Hallelujah. We are not looking for his presence. Where we say that as gathered in the presence of the Lord. You are the carrier. You are the carrier of the presence of your Father. Hallelujah. My God, you are the carrier. Like the way my son will go saying, I'm a son to Regina. You know, that one cannot, it is undisputable. You cannot dispute it. It is there and it cannot be changed. Hallelujah. So we are the carriers. We are carrying the deity. We are carrying that, we have the DNA of our Father. Hallelujah. So therefore, let us remain in him. Let us cultivate for that fellowship and let us maintain it there. Hallelujah. By obeying his commands in the name of Jesus. Now let us not grieve the Holy Spirit of God. Let us be so, particularly in these end times, my Jehovah. You cannot avoid this, because we are going to head to levels where some of these things, even the systems we are using, the phones and whatever, they are going to crush some of these things to, so that they can try and affect the church. But listen to this, my brother. The Bible says that the law of God will be written in our hearts in these end times. So you are able to reach God at whatever time. That's why we are seeing whatever kind of trials the disciples, the apostles of Jesus Christ went through. None of them was complaining. Philip is going through a scenario, my Jehovah God, and he's lifting his eyes amidst the stones that were laid on him, and he could see Jesus amidst that pain. That is now cultivate. Daniel is not calling for help. He's not even shouting. That is God for you. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying, this particular weekend, he's saying, oh, I want to align your life. I want to align the life of my people. And I want to align their lives when they cultivate their fellowship with me. Cultivate for that friendship. Cultivate labor. You know, labor, desire. How do you do this? You do this by obeying the commands of the Lord. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13. Hallelujah. The reason why we were, that the Bible says the whole duty of a man, Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13, is that we may fear God and obey his commands. That's the reason why we are alive. Hallelujah. That's the reason why we are on this face of the earth. Hallelujah. Obey God. Fear him and obey his commandments, and you're going to enjoy your life as a son of God in the name of Jesus. That's why we sometimes, thank you, the Spirit of God is telling me, because many of us are on and off. We sometimes declare the word of God and it becomes so ineffective. Hallelujah. Because there is a cut off somewhere. You know, when you say God, the Bible says, you know, he's trying to locate you, to locate the bearing, and he cannot, you know, you there's no attachment. Hallelujah. So remain in him. Remain in him. So when you quote the scripture, my God, that is what is happening to Jesus. Even in the wilderness, when the Spirit of God took him to be tested by the devil, you know, he's telling the devil, it is written. At the end of the day, we see the devil backing off, because what? Whatever is written, this Son of God has remained. That's why he can say, I always say what I hear my Father say. Now, my brethren, this morning, do you say what you hear your Father say? Well, where have you not said whatever your Father never said, my God, and it attracted warfare? Where have you gone where your Father never ordered your steps? Isaiah 30 and verse 21. The Bible says, when you turn to the right and to the left, behind you there is a voice telling you this is the way, go in it. So that is the kind of a relationship God wants to have with the church. Hallelujah. Where you can hear his voice, where he can hear your voice. Hallelujah. At whatever time. Hallelujah. God, the Bible says, you know, Hagar, that lad was crying because he was thirsty, and Hagar just sat far away, and she was just watching. She had nothing to do. And the Bible says, and God heard the cry of the lad. You know, that boy, God heard the cry of the children of Israel. He saw the pain, you know, he saw it, he saw whatever they were going through, and he heard their cry. Now that is God for you. God has ears. Hallelujah. His heart is not short that he cannot reach out and deliver you and save you. Hallelujah. So before you run for human deliverance, make sure you are afraid of God. Ah, Rama Hando Robozi. Hallelujah. Before you learn to sow another seed, because people have sowed this one, you run, you hide again from your pastor, you go somewhere else and do all those acadabras. No, even from where you are seated this morning, if you make God your friend, you are going to see a ton of events in the name of Jesus. I want to finish by saying, the Lord wants to align our lives so that we may fit in to that which he's doing to his people in this hour. I want to say we are in a season of reward. We are in a season where God has remembered his people. We are in a season where God has come to restore us. Thank you, my prophet Emmanuel. We are in a season where God is here to comfort you. God is going to comfort you without any labor. God will comfort you because you are his son. Hallelujah. We are in a season where God is going to compensate for your life. Hallelujah. We are in a season where the church is going to take control. We are dominating Genesis chapter 1. We are going to dominate. That is the reason where we are created, to have dominion. So the church is going to take dominion. We are going to have dominion of territories. Hallelujah. And we shall command in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So God is not coming down in person. We are his representation here. And I'm telling you the truth. God is looking for a man to walk with and to work with. Hallelujah. So abide in him. Abide in him. And you're going to, oh my God. Oh, I hear the Spirit of God say, it is going to be so smooth. It is going to be so easy. Hallelujah. Where you, that's why the Bible says, you know, when some of us will be taken before authorities, Jesus is saying, you even don't have to wonder what you're going to say. The Spirit of God will drop into you what you're supposed to say at that particular, that is God for you. When you go for interview, children of God, because we are in a season of where the children of God are being positioned. Hallelujah. Don't worry about some, just appear where you're Esther is saying, if I die, I die. And when she appears, there is the favor. This season, there is the favor where God wants to position you, because we're in a season of being rightfully positioned for our establishment. Hallelujah. Now listen to this. God will download for you. He can only download for you. Now listen to this. You cannot download anything, even in layman languages, even in our physical realm here. You cannot download anything on your phone unless it is connected to the internet. You cannot download anything. You cannot hear his voice. You cannot know the heart of God unless you remain connected to him. Hallelujah. So from this morning, before you fast again because of that issue, make sure your relationship with your father is okay. That is it. Hallelujah. Make sure you remain his friend. Hallelujah. Where you can say anything. You don't fear. You know, you just pour yourself. You know, we are singing some of these songs and they have no effect. And we lift our hands and we cry. We shed tears. But when we leave the presence, you know, whatever we call the presence of God. When we leave that joint fellowship, hallelujah, where we are fellowshipping together as a body, hallelujah. There's no effect. Hallelujah. I surrender, Lord, to you. Everything I give. Are you sure? Are you sure you have given him everything? Hallelujah. Your mind, your desires, your thoughts, your body. Hallelujah. Are you sure? Because when you do this, you enjoy salvation. You enjoy salvation. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord, may you allow the Lord to align your life this weekend. And when you gather, where you go for fellowship, whatever time you go for fellowship, even if it is a midweek fellowship, you are going to, oh my God, it is, I hear the Spirit of God say, it is going to be such a renewal. I hear in the Spirit of God, it's going to be such a renewal. It is going to be such a renewal in our spirits. When you cultivate for that personal fellowship with God, personal friendship with God, there's God, when we gather together, there's going to be such a renewal. Our worship will not be the same. My God, did you know, my brethren, you don't need a song. I'm a worshiper. I love worship. You don't need a song. You don't need even the instrument. You can just lift up your hands, even where you are this morning, and the Spirit of God will just operate on you in you, and you just bubble up in the Spirit. Oh my God, and you feel the renewal in your spirit without anybody. My God, I want to correct these things. Somebody take you in the presence of the Lord. Somebody take us in the presence of the Lord with a song. We don't have such scriptures. We don't have anything like that. Nobody can take you before the presence of the Lord with a song. Nobody can do that. There's nothing like that in the scriptures. Hallelujah. There's nothing like that in the scriptures. So remain in the presence of the Lord where you can access him, whether in the corporate worship or in a personal worship at whatever time, in the name of Jesus. So the Lord is saying, I want to align your life. I want to align your life so that you can fit in as my son. And I have always said that Jesus is not coming for Christians. Jesus is not coming for those who somebody poured waters on them to baptize them. By then, there is no such kind of baptism. Hallelujah. Where somebody has gone through some religious activities, my God of all glory. The Bible says those acts of righteousness, I just feel the lacks. Hallelujah. So Jesus is coming for his fellow brothers, sons of God. Jesus is coming for his body. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So let us cultivate. The word of the Lord this weekend is, even before we gather for worship tomorrow, for those who gather on Sundays, now, whatever time you gather, even if it every now, as a son of God, every moment is a worshiping moment. We are walking worshippers. We are walking carriers of the presence of God. We are his temples. Hallelujah. So anywhere, my God, we are on duty. Thank you. The Spirit of God is telling me, children of God are on duty 24/7. We are on duty. We are not on and off. We are on duty. Hallelujah. We are in the army of the Lord. Not singing, I'm in the army of the Lord. We are literally there. Hallelujah. So we know when the command has come, we know how to implement it. We know how to execute. Hallelujah. We know how to do it with no struggle in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So enjoy the renewal. Enjoy the Lord is some of you are so old. Can I minister for a few seconds? I hear the Lord say some of you are so wounded inside. They are so wounded. So even when we gather in corporate worship, there is a lot of pretense. And you pretend things are okay. You pretend that from inside you are okay, yet you're not okay. Now, we cannot pretend anymore. Can you go this morning? Can you appear? You know, can you face your father? Can you face your father this morning like the prodigal son? Can you face your father and tell your father, Father, this is my feeling. This, I'm hurt here. Father, heal there. Now, let me surprise you this morning. It's only the Spirit of God that can help you to forgive. I have been there many years ago, and God spoke to me and gave me a name. Somebody had hurt my life very, very bad many years ago, and the Lord gave me that particular name. After 5 years down the line, I was suffering in hate, and the Lord stopped me that time and told me, forgive so and so, and when you do this, I'm going to restore your life. I'm going to give you a new beginning, and I'm going to heal your life. Hallelujah. Heal your life, give you a new beginning, and restore you. And I'm telling you, I did it. I did not struggle. If you are still struggling to forgive, if you're still struggling to love, if you're still struggling with some sins, my God, the Lord is saying, be restored back, cultivate for my fellowship, cultivate for that personal friendship with me, because I am able to help you to get off this things. Hallelujah. A child of God should not be struggling with the sexual sins. Are you hearing me, church? We should not be struggling to live righteous lives. No, it is automatic. It flows from inside. Hallelujah. We should not be struggling to speak lies. You're struggling with the speaking of lies. My God of all glory, the Spirit of God should be stopping you even before you open your mouth. That is God for you. Hallelujah. So I hear the Spirit of God say, we are struggling with some of these sins because we have not cultivated. We have not labored to be friends to God. That personal cultivation where you decide to be a friend to your Father in the name of Jesus. And now the Lord is saying, where I'm seated. This is what the Spirit of God is saying. Now, this is going to be the beginning point of your restoration, and it is going to be an all-out restoration in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We don't struggle to pray. And I have said, it's not about shouting. I'm a shouting prayer person. No, it's not about shouting. My God, some praises you'll not even be able to shout. Hallelujah. But you're in prayer. My God, you're in prayer. Hallelujah. Somebody's talking to you, but you're in the spirit very far. Oh my God, I've always told people, sometimes you could be addressing me and I'm just far away. My body is there, but my spirit is connecting. I'm connecting, I'm downloading. And the next thing you see is that I've taken a pen and I'm writing and writing. Now that is it, because what? We are here, but we are not for here. So can we remain where we are supposed to remain? The Bible says that we are seated with Christ in heavenly places in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So the prophetic alignment, our breakfast this morning, before you take a cup of tea this morning, the Lord is saying, cultivate for that personal friendship with God, and you're going to enjoy the download from His throne of grace in Jesus' name. He'll tell you what you're supposed to do, whatever. He'll tell you what you're supposed to say, whatever. Even dressing, women, we don't even trust to struggle. My God, my Jehovah. That's why, oh my God, that's why some of us, we cannot copy styles. We don't copy nothing, because I'm an original. Hallelujah. My father will tell me, you, I want you to dress this way. For this particular season, this is the kind of dressing that is God for you. He's, oh my God, hallelujah. I'll do a conference one of these days, and it will be a blessing to all of us. So I hear the Spirit of God is telling me, somebody watching me is asking me, woman of God, how can I hear the voice of God? The apostles are here, they'll let you know. I don't have time to elaborate on that. When God will allow me to handle that, you can inbox me, then we can have a chat, because my time is up. Amen. So may the Lord help you to be aligned back. May the Lord help you to be aligned back. May that attachment of your life and God be restored. It does not matter what cut it off. It does not matter. I hear somebody here saying, woman of God, I used to hear God. I cannot hear the voice anymore. Now, I'll remind you the story of Abraham. Because of whatever Abraham messed up, calling, you know, somebody who was not supposed to be in his fellowship, that he could not hear the voice of God anymore. But the Bible says when he separated, immediately separated, God spoke to him again. So check on your association. Check on your association. Check on, yesterday I spoke to the church and I told the church, check on your association, because association will always assimilate you. Check on where you give. Hallelujah. Because giving is very key. Your tithe, your offering. Check on those things. Because those altars will always speak to your life. Hallelujah. Check on your giving, check on your association. Hallelujah. Check on even where you stay. Check on your environment. Hallelujah. Your daily environment. Because that one will determine how your walk with God is and how your life with God is in every moment of your walk in the faith, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So check your environment, check your association, check where you lay your seeds, your offering, and all of you. Check on all those things. There are so many things, but check on those things, and you're going to see the deliverance of the Lord in Jesus' name. I hear the Lord say, some people watching me who have been looking for deliverance, you don't need deliverance. Be restored back as a friend of God, and you're going to enjoy the faithfulness of God in Jesus' name. See, God bless you. See, Mungu abariki. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord watch over you. I have just released the word of God. That is your breakfast for you. Be aligned back to be a friend of God, and you're going to enjoy the download, even in these end times, by the grace of God in Jesus' name. God bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for watching. May the Lord bless you. Share the word of God. Share the word of God. Hallelujah. Share the word of God.